Hey guys, hello and welcome to Zen Innovations. In this particular video, we are going to look at how a digital voltage stabilizer actually works and what are the components inside it. So I have this 5 kVA automatic digital stabilizer opened up for one of my Hindi videos. Yes, I do make two original versions of each video. So if you love Hindi, link is there in the description. You can go and check it out. So I already have this hood open. And it's nothing special, it's just a bunch of screws. So let me open it and place it here. And here is how the insides of a stabilizer looks. So the first thing that grabs your attention is this huge, giant, pumpkin-like thing. Any guesses what is this? Well, this is nothing but a transformer. And traditionally, you might be accustomed to seeing those big, blocky, square transformers which use the EI core. And this is a newer type of transformer which is actually in a toroidal format. This is known as a toroid, by the way. It is a ring-shaped transformers, and technically they are superior to the EI ones, and hence they emit less heat. They are more reliable, they are more efficient. So having this thing in your machine is actually a thumbs up. So the basics of a stabilizer are something like this. Say if you are a particular power supply, the supply from your city transformer is not very good. Sometimes it's higher, sometimes it's lower, then this bad boy is going to change the stepping of its windings and then provide a regulated output. Let's look at the things one by one. So the first thing is this a big old very heavy pumpkin. So this pumpkin, or actually this transformer, has a variety of taps, as you can see. So one of them is going to be common, also known as the negative over here. And then you see a lot of taps. So 1, 2, 3. I presume these are the booster taps which are used for stepping up the voltage. Say if your input voltage is pretty low at 150, 160 volts, then one of these is going to get used, one of these threes. This might be a step down tap. So if your input supply is higher, say 260, 280 volts, this tap is going to step it down. So it has one step down tap and it has three booster taps, that is the step up taps. Plus there's this mysterious winding over here. Any guesses what is this? So guys, this thing actually provides power to the circuit. So here is the circuit, the PCB, or you can say the brains of this device. And earlier on, if you've taken a good look at the old school kind of stabilizers, then there used to be a small separate transformer, and its duty was there to just feed the power for the functioning of this circuit. Now we don't need that because this has been incorporated into the very same toroidal transformer, and this thing is going to provide say 12 volts, 24 volts or whatever is fit for this particular circuit, and it helps to run this circuit. And this circuit is the brain of this entire system, so it is going to decide like, oh, the input voltage is very low, let's step it up. Again, it will decide if the input voltage, oh, it's pretty high, let's bring it down. So that is what this thing is going to do. Let's take a close look at this thing. So this is the PCB of this stabilizer. You can see there are a lot of microchips, microcontroller, ICs, different diodes, resistance, all of this. And plus this thing is also powering the digital display, which is on the other side. So this thing is a nice little addition, and you can check out the kind of input voltage you are getting and what kind of corrected voltage your stabilizer is outputting to your sensitive load. It could be an air conditioner, it could be a computer, it could be washing machine, fridge. Almost every kind of appliance is supported on this kind of stabilizer. And I have already connected this kind of stabilizer to my inverter. The video is right here. That's a very clever way to do it, and that safeguards a lot of your home appliances at once with just a single stabilizer. So this is the PCB, all right, and the PCB has these wires coming through it, and the wires here goes to the switching section. So this switching section is made up of variety of relays, and one of them relays would be for high cut, low cut. So if your input voltage is way off, like it's going way beyond whatever this thing can support, then it is simply going to turn off your load, and that safeguards your home appliance. So this is a simple relay, just two pins simply. It disconnects the positive. So this is the positive, this is the positive towards the output. It simply disconnects that and your appliance gets turned off. Let me focus on this thing. So this is the simple relay that completely disconnects. This is also used for the time delay function. So when the product is turned on, it waits for say 10 seconds, 5 seconds, and then it turns on the load, which helps for, you know, it helps the grid voltage to stabilize a little bit. So that is one relay. Then there are two relays over here, these two things, and these are you know, these are double throw kind of things. So there's one NC and there's one NO, that is normally open and normally connected terminals. So you can say that sort of these two relays are doing the work of four relays. In traditional old school stabilizers, there used to be four or five relays, but now they have this NONC kind of stuff, and that helps to get the job done with just two relays. So well, that is what my job is done today. Your job is just to hit that nice little like button as well as subscribe to this channel. And if you're interested in watching more informative videos like this, there's a playlist waiting for you in the description below. The playlist is known as Electronics 101. So that was it on Zen Innovations today, guys. I hope you liked it. Take care and have a nice day.